A national survey by YouGov has this week announced that Britain's favourite food is none other than the humble Yorkshire pudding. From the survey, 85% of Britons who have tried Yorkshire puddings said they liked them. This is closely followed in second place by Sunday roasts and fish and chips, both on 84%.
Well, I mean, they've been important to Yorkshire for decades, quite frankly. So we thought we'd better get our thinking caps on, and we are launching a challenge called the Great Yorkshire Pudding Challenge. It's in partnership with YorkBid and the Cookery School at the Grand Hotel in York.
To celebrate the results, a nationwide challenge is being launched to find out who can make the best Yorkshire pudding meal.
There's a lot of people who don't get the chance to create something that's wonderful, and we want to hear from them as well. So you don't have to be a chef. You don't have to already be in the industry. You just have to have creativity and come up with something that's just different.
But what makes a good Yorkie?
I really like Yorkshire puddings when they're really crispy and a lot of gravy, so it's just nice and juicy, you know.
Yorkshire puddings are an essential part of a roast dinner. Like, you need them. Without them, the roast dinner's not really complete. Covered in gravy, just like the rest of the roast dinner, pretty much.
Well, I'd say sort of homemade ones over shop bought. One that sort of has a bit of oil, but isn't too oily. It's sort of, you know, you've got to get that balance right. You don't want it to be sodden, but equally, you don't want it to be completely bland and tasteless. And
if it's too crispy, it's like too dry. So you need that bit of softness on the bottom, but not soggy. Soggy is bad, because then everything falls out the bottom.
It's got to be a Yorkshire pudding that rises. It can't be just flat. I mean, I've seen some that are just flat, that go nowhere. They're awful. And it has got to have some crispiness on the outside. A little bit of doughy on the base, not too doughy, not too spongy, a little bit crispy, but crispy on the outer.
And the winner will be set for a special reward.
You can upload your photos and also your recipes. The public will judge, and then the finalists, where there'll be eight of them, will be coming to York on the 1st of August to the Cookery School at the Grand Hotel. And the judges will decide who has created the best dish. There's an opportunity for whatever you create to be put on our menu.
So whether you make a savoury dish or a sweet treat, it's down to Britain to find out who can do justice for the nation's favourite food. Kit Taylor, That's TV.